But I haven't made the telephone pole yet. How am I able to answer the phone?
Not my Barbara.
Tom, let me go. I promised it'd be good. Please, untie me, naughty boy. I will help you reach your masterpiece. I will love you forever.
No, you're not my Barbara. Barbara loved being tied up.
Husband refused to do as he was told. All he had to do was write what I wanted him to write.
Now you will never get her back.
I am much older than you.
Older than your first work of art.
I will find a new face to wear.
Someone else to dream me free.
Feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong. There's a long journey through the night back into the light.
No.
ground control to Major Tom. Ground control to Major Tom. Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. Ground control to Major Tom.
Man, this game has a really good soundtrack.
Check ignition and may God's love be with you.
Credits are long. Long credits are long. So that was Alan Wake. Pretty good game. I see GameSpot gave it an 8 out of 5. I don't think I'd go that high. Maybe a 7.5. Say 8 out of 5. 8.5, rather. 8.5 out of 10. It was good. I can't help but be frustrated by the fact that there were so many opportunities for them to have done better. If they would have just... I don't know. It's like, I can't pinpoint any one thing that they did wrong to be like, this is the thing that they need to replace. Overall, it was just sort of like a generally a subpar experience. I mean, subpar from like AAA, but it wasn't AAA, so I suppose, oh well. Yeah, the music for this game has been amazing. Except for the songs that they clearly made specifically for this game, those suck. But all of the other songs are amazing. It's like one of the best video game soundtracks I've ever heard in my life. There is a lot of room for improvement in the story itself. I mean, the themes and the overall plot is fine. Would have been great. But the detail of it is pretty terrible. The writing is bad. The faces I couldn't get over. The faces, especially of his wife, like, they're just terribly done. They're bumpy. Like, the skeleton structure underneath is very lumpy. They didn't do a very good job of mapping a face. Like, a general human, like, skull shape. Everybody had an overbite. Nobody knew how to close their mouth. Everybody looked like they'd been stung by bees. It was kind of like when they did the, Olivia Munn, was it? In Mass Effect 3? Like, Olivia Munn's character, I think it was Olivia Munn, in Mass Effect 3 had the very much like the same feeling. Like, they tried really hard to make the faces look like real people, but it was like I don't know. They spent too much time focusing on little details that really should have been left out. I don't know. The mechanics are fine. I liked the combat system. I got used to the parrying and started to like it. It in the sense that it was still really annoying that I had to do it, but when I got a series of parries that made it so that I wasn't taking damage during battle, it felt really good. Like, it felt like an accomplishment. But, man, the difficulty spikes were just really bad. And the fact that pretty much every single enemy in the latter half of the game, when they hit you once, they would then enter a combo where they would do your entire health bar worth of damage, was a really shitty thing to do. Especially with how infrequently the checkpoints happened in the game. And that's another thing. That I really think they could have focused on a little better. If they want to do horde mode style, like, waves of enemies, they need to have more intelligent checkpointing. Like, they it's something that happens a lot of times in games that do the sort of the same sort of system that they did in this one with the checkpoints, where they base their checkpoints on like XYZ coordinate triggers rather than like progression through the level. Like they do it based on like physical character location. So I can run like beeline towards a checkpoint, which otherwise I would have to make it through a gauntlet to get to. Instead, they essentially have to play through the level, and then based on how the level is set up and the flow of the level, they then have to determine where the checkpoints would go. Yeah, these credits are really long. Maybe if I was more into classic rock, I would have liked the original tracks okay, but you know my stance on that, Chi. I can imagine Arkham City's credits taking forever. Also, the GTA series has really long credits too. For a similar reason, if you ever look at like the budget that goes into those because of how many people they hire to do those games is ridiculous. In order to get it cranked out in like 2 years, like the publishers are expecting, they wind up having to hire hundreds of people. Yeah, I can't remember. I'm trying to remember how many people or how much money went into GTA 4, and when people were like, "How could you possibly spend that much money on GTA 4?" It's like, in order to get it out in the amount of time that our publisher required, we wound up having to hire like 300 people. Are any of these names recognizable? You know who I hated? As much as I said that I hate Barry and I hate Sarah, and I did. Wait, there is a real Alice and Alan Wake? What? Or was that just like a really weird way for them to do the credits? I really, really hated the FBI agent. Holy crap, there was absolutely nothing redeeming about that character. Like, they tried to make you hate him because he was a dick, but I hated him because his lines were so terrible and his delivery was somehow even worse than that. Chili Vodka was his nickname. Okay. Coconut. I'm about to put on some slippers. I don't like wearing socks. Bare feet are happy feet, Eli. I'll be there as soon as I'm done casting the R. And done casting and then go out that door and through over to the couch so that I can lay down and eat caramel popcorn and watch you play Shadow of the Colossus. And I hope to see everybody else in VR's channel for Shadow of the Colossus. You should just mute my video. I say, though you wouldn't be able to hear me say it if you had muted my audio. Oh, my controller turned off. Yay! I now have nightmare mode unlocked, which I will never ever do. Let's see my stats. Birds killed 823. Holy shit. Wow. I was nowhere near complete on coffee or pages. 106 page book in this game, essentially. I mean, there's like a novella in this game. It's just unfortunate that it really sucks. They kind of made a sequel a little bit, Chitara. There's Alan Wake's American Nightmare, which is kind of like Alan Wake 1.5. It was like an Xbox Live and PlayStation Network style game, and I also have that. And I may play that tomorrow. I don't know how long it is. I don't know. I'm thinking about it. Let's see. Pyramids knocked over. 5 of 12. Chests found. 24 of 30. Wow, I missed one TV show. I almost got all the TV shows. I did find a Night Springs video game. I just didn't know I could do anything with it. And I found plenty of cardboard standees. I don't remember seeing any alarm clocks, though. Oh, look at that. That's pretty sweet. Orbison, there you go. A candy-colored clown, they call the Sandman. Oh, this is the episode one, like, you finished episode one song. Go to sleep, everything is alright. Kind of surprised that there wasn't more music in episode one than just Coconut and this. Well, everybody head to VR's channel, which is, I will type out for you because I'm a nice guy. There you go. I'll see you guys there. He will be on Colossus number 4 in Shadow of the Colossus, which is a fun one, especially for somebody who's new to the game. Though the one after that is the one that I'm hoping to watch. I think it's the one after that. It's either 5 or 6. It's a fun one. I can't wait to watch him do that one. Anyway, hope to see you guys there. Goodbye. Thanks for watching.